Welcome back. Well, researchers from the University of Michigan released new findings on cases of hearing loss. And joining us this morning is Dr. Kristen Connors. And thank you so much again for joining us really early this morning. Let's just start out about what Apple found out from, or rather about tinnitus. They had a new survey that came out. What can you tell us about the findings of this survey, Dr. Connors?
Yes, hi, good morning. The study showed that what they were looking for was the incidence of tinnitus among different age groups. And they found that as people are older, they experience a higher rate of tinnitus, which is a ringing in the ears. It's a perception of sound that other people do not hear.
Okay, and is that something that, I know you said it's more common in older folks, but with earbuds and more people listening, you know, to music and, you know, different programs with those earbuds, you know, so tightly in their ears, are younger folks experiencing this more too?
Yes. Yeah, they are. We're seeing it a lot more. It's a lot more common in our office now than it was 10 and 20 years ago, identifying those younger people that experience tinnitus as well. So yes, it is growing with headphone use and just noise exposure, concerts, just being exposed to loud sounds and not taking care of any, not using any sort of prevention to avoid tinnitus, yeah.
Okay, so what types of things can people do to try to prevent this from happening? And if it does happen, is there any, you know, treatment, any method to reverse it?
So there really, once you have tinnitus, it is really hard to reverse it. The number one thing we always tell patients, people to do is you always need to have some sort of ear protection. Whether you're mowing the lawn, whether your work history, you know, if you're a carpenter and you're around loud equipment, if you're going to concerts, to always try to think about what you can get to protect your hearing while you're exposed to those sounds. You can get something as simple as over-the-counter products where they're earplugs that you just put in, or you could get something that's more of a custom type product for people that are in those environments on a regular basis and want something that's going to really protect and be a lot more comfortable for them to wear for extended periods of time.
All right. Well, Dr. Connors, thank you so much for that great information. You can find more info about those treatments at prescriptionhearing.com. Stick with us. Our top stories are next.